Hello, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, A Tear of Vermillion, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now leaving the Grand Cathedral. The monsters showing up the highways are becoming more and more violent. Please be careful. I don't know if I should go around talking to all these people again. It looks like things are going smoothly on looking for the sacred treasures. Keep up the good job. Alright, well, he definitely never said that, so I guess we'll go look around some more. We're supposed to be heading out to the, I think that would be the northeast door. If I'm wrong, well, the game will stop me. West is Quit. I'll protect Quit. You take care of yourselves, too. So it's probably not gonna let us go this way. Yeah. Ruti says, we have no business in Quit. Let's get to Garden Hill as soon as possible. And by as soon as possible, not that soon. The recent increase in the number of monsters is unusual. Is Octum's Apostles pulling the strings behind? Just like they did when they took Cathedral 8 years ago? Pulling the strings behind. Oh, hi, Lucius. Tio says, Lucius says, good to see you again. You're in good spirit. Teehee, being in good spirit is my only virtue. Did you come here to look for a job, Lucius? No, I'm not taking any job for a while. I'll be traveling. Really? I'm speechless. You'll be gone. I'm so devastated I'll lose sleep over it. Was there something going on between these two? Haha, you're exaggerating. Don't worry, once my journey is over, I'll come back to Valkd. It's a promise. What's going on with these two? Lucius, please be careful. You must come back safely. Hi, Lucius. It's been a while, Ramona says. And you too, Douglas. What strange luck brought you two together? We're bound by fate, Douglas says. Shut your mouth, says Lucius. You look good yourself, Ramona. I hear you've been making a lot of money. Not as much as you, but this month I'll beat you by percentage of jobs successfully completed. It's a pity I can't compete with you, Lucius says. I have something else to do. I won't be working as an adventurer for a while. Really? I hope you're not escaping my challenge. Anyway, I'll make tons of money while you're away. I don't know what you're up to, but best of luck. Thank you. You take care of yourself too, Ramona. And who's this one? Blade? Douglas, could you spar with me when you have time? I want to see how good the techniques of the famous Sword Saint are. Haha, alright then. I've always wanted to fight with you, seriously. You always did it jokingly before. I'll be looking forward to witnessing the techniques you learned from the Sword Saint. Oh, I thought he was saying he was the Sword Saint. Monsters are wreaking havoc on the eastern continent. I heard it from a pilgrim visiting the holy capital. You believe everything you hear from pilgrims? We haven't seen the girl you're looking for in this tavern, Ronette says. She may be in the Grand Cathedral. I'm not looking for a girl. I've looked everywhere, but she is nowhere to be found. Maybe she's talking to the butler. I have no other choice but to contact the Adventurer Guild. Please forgive my powerlessness. Alright. She may be facing danger as I speak. Ugh, I just can't sit here and wait. Then don't. The Adventurer Guild is very close. This came from there. Hey, you're still here. I thought you had already left for the east. Avon says, I've been wondering, how come you know so much about us? You seem to know Gawain, too. Do you belong to the church or something? I told you before, I don't believe in Bardas. Of course, I'll sing in a chapel if requested. Uti says, then your faith is in... Girl, you think wrongly. I don't believe in light or darkness. It's not that I abhor them. I do sympathize with the spirits, but I don't worship them. Then what do you believe in? My tribe has no right to believe in anything. Your tribe? Says Avon. That's enough. If you have the time to delve into my personal life, then travel to the Eastern Continent to accomplish your mission. Okay, Avon says. So how long will you be singing here? It depends on the wind and song. I may leave tomorrow, or I may be here singing 1 year from now. If we ever meet again, I'll sing a song for you, free of charge. I'm looking forward to it, Avon says. So long. May your journey be blessed with good songs. We want to hire adventurers to escort us, but they're hard to find. We have tough luck finding them, given the current situation. Well, there's some right across the street there. You are adventurers, right? Would you like to become our bodyguards? We'll pay you good money. Avon says, I'm sorry, but we have things to do. You've accepted another job already, huh? I guess we didn't have luck. Call me when you're done with your job. I want you to escort us to Brazak. Yeah. Don't call us, we'll call you. Who's that? Merchant Barlax says, I have a problem. I got back my treasures, but now they're suspecting my connection with the Great Oracle. What should I do? You should just kiss it all goodbye, dude. Old Man Joy. It was a great pilgrimage, all thanks to the blessings of Bardas. It should become a good memory for my grandchild. Is this the grandchild, then? The adventurer who helped us went back to Baloa already. I wanted to say goodbye to him. Well, too late. Snooze, you lose. It's fine. Oh, stimulant. Thanks. Dicks. Merchant there. Oh. Another one. Thank you. Alright. We went in here. Ew, get up. I used up all my savings being lazy. It's time I went to the guild and take some jobs. So you're an adventurer, Avon says. You look nothing like it, says Ortiz. Douglas says, he's an old-timer around here. Lucia says, he's lazy, but he always completes his jobs without fail. Lucius, Douglas, you work too hard. Work whenever you feel like working, and take a rest once you've made some money. That's the ideal life of an adventurer. Lucia says, how can you keep yourself fit living a life like that? He is not giving away his secret for that. I don't think he'd be selling anything new, would he? Battle Beak? Yeah. They seem to always have the same things. You have to go to a new town to get new things. Oh. And that guy sells pet food and stuff. I'll work hard to become a great person, I don't want my parents to laugh at me. How the hell will they laugh at you? It seems the shipments from Berserk arrived. At least, at last, we have fresh ingredients to cook with. Let's cook a feast tonight. You can cook the feast tonight. We'll be gone. The monsters infesting the highway are getting stronger by the day. The same thing happened 8 years ago. It was right before Cathedral was occupied. Alright, let's see what else is in this section. I think that's it. Other than if we try to go down, I don't think we can get down from here. We have to go to the next. According to Meister, the strongest adventurer is Lightning Douglas. Really? Never heard of him. He's right, says Douglas. Hmm, says Lucius. But also according to Meister, Douglas sometimes botches up. Based on the percentage of jobs successfully completed, Sapphire Eyes is the number one. Wow. Haha. Sapphire Eyes. Darn it, says Douglas. Back at. Meister told me, Lightning Douglas and Sapphire Eyes don't have a good partner. Ramona and Blade is the best pair based on the overall score. Lucius and Douglas go, hmm. Okay. The monsters are increasing along the highway. I can't just sit here feeling terrified. There must be something I can do. Well, you're a kid, so there's nothing you can do. At least I think you're a kid. Maybe you just look like a kid because everyone looks like kids. The paladins and adventurers are fighting for us. There's nothing we can do. You tell your buddy over there, then. Ruti says, what are we doing in the underground waterway? Walking around. I was thinking of another town or... Oh, yeah, there is a door down there. That's what I was looking for. Over there in a second. My brother wants to become an adventurer. Even with all the backing of the royal family, adventurers basically live a hand-to-mouth life. It's a financially unstable profession. I must change his mind quickly. Alright. Quickly. Geez, we're adventurers. We have plenty of money. Alright, there's another door down there. Let's go check these places out. Valk developed into the holy capital because of the power of Asperius, the previous supreme priest. He moved most of the church's administrative functions from Cathedral to Valkd. Looking back now, Master Asperius might have predicted the tragedy in Cathedral. Can't get anywhere from here, I don't think so. Well, we can go over here. It just leads over there. North is Theta, that's the way we're going. I'll talk to them on the way out. Just one other door down there I want to get to. Yeah, I see it. Oh, that's him. I was in this one. Wait. There's another door. I see. Yeah, right there. Okay, how do I... I can just walk through there from here, right? Okay. Meow, 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 meow. Yes, fascinating. It's almost dinner time. My job is to prepare a meal for Ruru by mixing the leftovers of my mother's cooking. Ruru? That's a mother. I think. Iona? They say some village on the other side of the ocean is breeding dogs to pull sleds. Our Ruru is smart, so we want to teach him many tricks, but he's still a capricious cat. Oh, Ruru's the cat. Oh well, capriciousness is one of the appeals of cats. They also say an animal that gives off a lovely smell is living across the ocean. I'm curious about how it looks like. Are you curious about what it smells like? I think they're talking about those cute little things that went... How'd they go? Mune? Mune? I forgot what they're called. The fur of a rare animal called Mifa, thank you, the Mifas, became fashion among the rich a while ago. However, the Bardas Church issued an order the other day banning all transactions of Mifa's fur. Of course, we the commoners have nothing to lose from the ban. Yep, the Mifas, yeah, that's what she's talking about. Alright, no one up here, right? Here, we'll check with these people. The key to becoming a successful businessman is to understand the current situation and read the future. I should start bringing my son to the actual dealings to familiarize him with the business. He's a smart kid. He'll certainly become a better businessman than I am. Yeah, maybe. Do you want to be a businessman? I've always known I'm not cut out for being a merchant. I want to study history at the Grand Cathedral or Sorcery School. Okay, so he doesn't want to be a businessman. But I don't think my father will let me. Can we talk to him now about it? Try to convince him? No? Okay. I thought it was like a mini quest or something. So this way is Brazak. We are not going that way. We'll defend the southern border of the Holy Capital. Okay, well that's good because you're in the southern area. You adventurers have done enough already. It's our turn to show the monsters what we can do. Okay, now they're gonna say we don't go that way. The priest told us to go to Garden Hill. Let's head for the north exit. Right, here we go. Who's this? Well, the shipments finally arrived from Brazak, thanks to the adventurers who escorted the transport. The pair, Ramona and Blade, is not bad, or are not bad. They may be as good as Lucius the Sapphire Eyes and Lightning Douglas. Oh, Sapphire Eyes is Lucius? Lucius says, Blade is cool-headed and has superior skills. He's different from a frivolous person like you. Is he talking to Douglas? I wish you were as lovable and friendly as Ramona, he says. What did you say? Lucia said. I didn't say anything. Even says they should learn to get along from Ramona and Blade. The Paladin's hands are tied with defending the Holy Capital. We'll still be counting on the Adventurer Guild. Alright, let's hope they don't let you down. We continue to patrol the Holy Capital Highway, but the monsters don't seem to be decreasing at all. What's going on? They are breeding at an exponential rate. So you're going to Theta. The monsters are becoming increasingly violent. Please be careful. Yippers. Holy Capital Highway. Let's wait for the sign to go away so we can see. Okay. The monsters have become violent. Oh, they're afraid of us. At least these are. Yeah, I don't think we have anything to fear from these monsters. I don't really like the backtracking, I'm gonna say that much. But it's not a long way between towns. So we should be there shortly. Is this where we were racing with that wagon pulled by monsters or something? It might not have been monsters, it might have been horses. North is Theta. Sweet. So we made it all this way. I remember the song. Captain Malian says, I requested the capital to reinforce the soldiers. I feel a little insecure about being here with only three people. I hope they will come soon. Yeah, I'd say three people is not a lot. Please count on us guarding the highways to the Holy Capital. I will defend to the death in honor of the King's army. You're not guarding the highways. You're guarding the town. The highways are full of monsters and there's not a single soul to be found fighting them. Well, no, I will not count on you, sir. The monsters intruded into town the other day. They give us a hard time, but I brought one down. I guess I owe it to my training. And all these people... Giamaine! Ah, Avon, dear. How are you? Hi, Giamaine. Are you looking for Mr. Karamas again? Actually, not this time. I caught him in this town, so I'm making him right now. Anyway, Avon, dear, Quick Raven, whose story's model is you, sells like crazy. Why is that in quotes? There are many stores which sold out the book. It's selling as good as his former work, Swordswoman Safi. I really have to thank you. Oh, he wrote the Safi books, too? Good for you, says Avon. I think Quick Raven will be his most important work. You haven't seen him yet, have you? Please go see him a little. He may be able to inspire you with something. You mean we would be able to inspire him with something? By the way, it's nice to see you again, good-looking. Is this our destiny? Ha ha ha! Stop that! Who are you talking to? Douglas? Don't be shy. You're making me shy, too. Douglas says, Avon? Avon says, don't talk to me. Oh, I almost forgot. Here is Quick Raven, Volume 6. Please look it over. I know this is going to be a million seller. Quick Raven 6. Alright, sweet. Talk to him. Hale? I heard that the monsters are outbreaking at Beloa. A passenger of the ferry boat was complaining about it. Hi, may I help you? Today's course menu is mayonnaise risotto, eggplant marinated with grated radish and spices as an entree, and a strawberry muffin for dessert. Strawberry muffin sounds great. The menu stimulates my appetite, Douglas says. I would love to order it if the boat arrives late. Is he serious? Says Avon. Lucia says, that guy eats anything, no matter what the combination may be. We'll serve you tea with a muffin. Have an elegant afternoon. Have an elegant afternoon. Oh, is that what's his name over there? Are you writing? What's up, great writer? How's it going? Oh, Avon. Doing pretty good, thanks to you. Oh, you are... Kay, says Lucius. Oh, she was like, K? I was like, Karamuro Karamas. Hello, Sapphire Eyes Lucius. It's been a while. Oh, no. How come I always come across with people I don't want to see? Ruti says, do you know him, Lucius? I got to know this old man when I had just become an adventurer. He said, since you're an adventurer, I'm sure you have so many thrilling and breathless experiences. Why don't you contribute to the art? Please tell me your experiences because I can't come up with any topics. And he followed me around persistently. I see, says Avon. You did pretty much the same thing to Lucius. Lucius says, after all, he wrote a novel called Saffy based on my experiences. What? This is Swordswoman Saffy? Like, you can't see me, but my mouth is hanging open. I read those books. I made videos of them, if you guys want to see them. But, yeah, so this is Swordswoman Saffy. We found those books in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. And they're also present in this game as well. Since then, I've got the image as a swordswoman in the novel. It's hard to get around. Well, anyways, says Karamas, have you had any adventures I can write about? Your experiences were the best to write about. I don't have anything to tell you, says Lucius. But he's talking to Avon. Because of the novel, I've been greatly suffering. Douglas says, well, anyways. Lucius says, what do you mean by well? Hey, old man, Lucius doesn't like it. Why don't you stop involving her, says Douglas. Douglas, says Retief. Douglas says, if you don't like it. Avon says, if you don't like it? Douglas says, I'll be your model instead. Write cool novels to your heart's content. Karama says, nope. How come? A shabby man can't be a model of grand drama. Shock! He yells shock like that? I can hear from Sapphire Eye sometime later, Karama says. Let's see, Avon, do you have any good stuff you can tell me? I guess he was talking to her, yeah. You're a hopeless writer, says Avon. Avon told him what had happened so far. Wow. Mm-hmm. I see. This is good stuff. I'm enlightened. This is discrimination, says Douglas. The fire of a creative work is surging up from the literal spring of my heart. Ceaseless water is falling in drops. Then, oh, I gotta write, right now. Lucia says, Avon, I won't take any responsibility for this. Krama says, thank you for your cooperation. Here I come, I can write. Here goes, like, I'm getting off. You're doing what? Good, the next work will be a million seller too. Alright, let's get out of here since he's either writing or getting off or both. Let's see what's upstairs. It's just her, she's not gonna say anything. There's nobody else up here. Well, I can't believe it's been a half hour all we've been doing is talking to people. And walking from one town to another. Last time, wasn't there someone around here or something? I don't know. Oops. What was a stutter? Alright, then that goes over to the piers. Oh, hi! Do you want to play hide-and-seek with me? Hell, Nora. The man with the white beard gave me candy. His name is Uncle Gawain.
Oh.
Gawain, we know him well. Oh, you're getting these stutters. Sailor Alno says, I'm proud of the ferry boat, but I would love to have a boat like the famous Planetos, which can sail freely. I would love to board it if I had the chance. I'm working. Come around the counter. You're working, huh? Master Gawain said that he was going toward the capital, so I treated him with some drinks. He opened more than 10 bottles. He is quite a drinker. Is he really a sage? Alright, well, you don't... You're working, but you don't have anything... to... Never mind. Never mind. Oh, that's right, there's some more shops around here. Don't come in here. Come around to the front of the counter. I love doing that to them. Some of them, like, you can't get over there. We are also training our body every day, but the monsters are also getting harder to deal with. We have to devote ourselves more than now. More than... now? You mean more now? West is dork, so we're not going that way. Oh! It lets us go that way. I'm surprised. I was waiting for the, you know, we can't go that way. We have to take a boat from here. Alright, so that's what's up here, not the docks. To that lighthouse that's always closed up. Ah, she's the one we have to talk to. I was wondering. Can we just go past her and talk to the others first? Nope. Lessaria says, would you like to ride a regular liner? Please follow the necessary procedure to aboard. Oh, we have to talk to her first. So we're probably beginning leaving. I don't need a rare potion. So I'm just going to read this book really quick, and that'll be the end of the episode. So if you guys want to tune out now, if you're not interested in hearing it. Otherwise, we'll be writing this, reading Quick Raven 6, Volume 6, Foregone Dreams. By Karamuro Karamas. Panting, Ravin and Marl were running through the nighttime road. Ravin held a book firmly. They were able to take advantage of a chance to escape the inn at the same time. The timing and teamwork between the two was the result and advantage of working for so long together. But the enemy easily caught up and cast a flame spell from behind Ravin. Ravin jumped away immediately, but the sorcerer was expecting that. He cast another spell while Ravin was in the air. This time he cast a lightning spell. Pain shot through Raven's body. Ravin fell and tumbled on the ground. Ravin, Marl ran to Raven's side. Run, Raven gasped and lost consciousness. Raven thought that he heard Marl say to him, I'll protect you. Raven was watching a dream from long ago. There was a time when Raven got drenched with water while playing with Marl. Raven was freezing because the water absorbed all of Raven's body heat. Yeah, it'll do that. To make things worse, the wind was blowing without any mercy. It's cold. I want to go home, Raven thought. Suddenly he came to his senses. Huh? He opened his eyes. It's cold. When did I fall asleep? He thought. He could almost hear his childhood friend telling him that he'd catch a cold if he slept like this. He was still drifting in between dream and reality when he tried to wipe his body dry. Then he felt a slippery sensation. He opened his eyes. He saw himself laying in a pool of blood. His back hurt, but he realized it wasn't his blood. He stopped breathing. Cold sweat trickled down his back. Marl! Marl! Where are you? He called the name of his lifelong friend. If this is not my blood... If this is not my blood, then... Arrgh! Raven's scream sounded in the night, and the wind carried it through the town. Wow. It's a sad scene indeed. Mirroring real life, or, well, this real life. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. See you guys next time. We take a boat ride to whatever gardens and throw away a rare potion and another one. Anyway, thanks so much. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm trying to get off with the cats finding stuff. Always seek adventure.